So hello students, in this video we will do the remaining sums of exercise 6.3. For each of the following numbers, find the smallest whole number by which it should be multiplied. We have done one sum in the last video. So here I am taking suppose 1008. So I have already told you, first of all we have to do prime factors. So it is 504. Now 252, 126, 63, 63. So you can see here all the factors we have received, and there is one factor which is not in pair form. 2 is in pair form, these 2 in pair form, these 2, but this one is not in pair form. Therefore, it is not a perfect square. So, how can we make a perfect square? By multiplying something. So, it means we will be right here. 7 should be multiplied to make what? 1008. A perfect square, right? Now what will be the result after multiplying? So it is 7056. And if I see the factors of 7056, now I am getting 2 into 2 2 into 2 3 into 3 and 7 into 7. So it will be in the square form, because actually through this square we identify. And question is asking for this, you have to find the square root of this perfect square also. So what is the square root of this perfect square? We know that we will see the square root only. So 2 into 2 into 3 into 7, so it is 84, I hope, right? So this is the question number 5. I think other parts you can do yourself. Now I am doing question number 6. Question number 6 is saying, by what number we have to divide? By what number we have to divide? So it is, suppose I am taking 252, we have done already in the first one. So I am taking 2925. Right. So this is divided by 3, first of all. Now again, now it is divided by 5, and now 1. So it means 2925 is containing 3 into 3, 5 into 5 and 13. 13 is not in pair form. It means, because of this 13, it is not a perfect square. So, and our question is asking, by what number we have to divide? If question is, by what number we have to multiply, then we will say by 13. By what number we have to divide? 13. By 13, it should be divided. By 13, it should be divided to make it perfect square. Right. So 2925 divided by 13. Definitely it will divide completely because it is a factor. 3, 13, 2 jar, 26. So it is 2. 26, it is 3, sorry. So 3, 13, 2 jar, 6, 26, and then 6 and 5. So 2 to 5 we are getting, and 2 to 5 will have factor 3 into 3. And 5 into 5, because this 13 we have eliminated. Now what is the square root of 2 to 5 here? 3 and 1 5. So it is 15. Right. Now question number 7 I am doing here. Other parts I hope you can do yourself. If any doubt comes, you can ask me on YouTube, you can comment there. then I can give you the solution same on the same time. Right, now question number 7. Question number 7 is related to word formula. The student of class 8 of a school donated 2401 in all for a Prime Minister National Relief Fund. Each student donated as many rupees as the number of students in the class. Okay, first of all, we will try to understand the meaning of this. Total amount, we will write it total amount donated. Right, total amount donated is 240. And the condition is, if suppose for example I am taking, there is a, you know, 8th class, and in 8th class suppose 40 students are there. So every student will pay 40 rupees. If there are suppose 35 students in a class, so every student will pay 35 rupees. So total amount they will get 40 into 40, 1600 in this case. Right, and in this case it will be 35 square. So 25, right, and 3 4s are 12. So it is like this. So it means what we are doing, the amount donated by each student depend on the number of student in the class. But here nothing is given. So what we will do here, that there are X students in a class, right? So amount donated by each student will be rupees A also. Now total amount paid, total amount paid by A students will be A into A, right? So it will be A square rupees, because each student is paying rupees A and number of students are A, so we will multiply. And total amount is given in the numerical form also, so it means they both are same. This one we have found with the help of variable, and this one is given, it means both are equal. So A square will be equal to 2401. So A is equal to 2401. This square will shift here, and what we have to do here, we have to find the square root of 2401. Now what you will do, again prime factorization, and I think we have divided by 7 here. 7 3s are 21, 3 7 4 3 7 7 3s are 6, sorry, 7 4 and 9 7, and this one is 7. So it means it is coming 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. What we are taking? 1 7 from this, 1 7 from this, because it is in the square form, right? And we take the root part only. So it is 7 into 7, it is 49. So it means 49 students were there in the class, and they have, each student has donated 49 rupees. Right? So now question number 8 is similar sum, but story is changed. The story is, there are 2025 plants. 2025 plants, and each row contains as many plants as number of rows. So again, total number of plants is equal to 2025. Let number of rows be x. Okay, I am telling you, if there are 5 rows, 1 2 3 4 5, so 5 plants will be here. This is the condition. Same number of rows and same number of plants. If we are taking 10 rows, then we have to take 10 plants in each row. So here what we are doing, let the number of rows be x. So number of plants in each row will be x. So in my language, in the form of x, number of plants in x rows will be x into x, right? So x into x will be equal to, because this is the also the number of lengths, so x square will be equal to 2025 and x is equal to root 2025. Now here I will find the square root by prime factorization. So this is 3 divided by 3, 3 6 are 18, 2 3 7 1 3 5. Now 3 2 and 25, now it will be 3, now it is 5, so it is. Now we will write here, it will be 3 square and it is 5 square, right? So we will write the root part only here, because this square root will cancel the squares. So 3 into 3 into 5, you can understand like this, this square root will cancel the squares. So it is 45, so it means there are 45 rows and 45 plants, right? Now question number 9, question number 9 is again easy sum. Okay, in this question, find the smallest square number that is divisible by 4, 9 and 11. Sorry, 10. Divisible by. Okay. Can you tell me the difference between LCM and HCF? Because HCF divides the numbers and LCM divided by the numbers. So what we have to do? Because we have to find that number which is divisible by these three numbers. It means we have to find the LCM. So LCM of 4, 9 and 10. So we know the LCM. There is this procedure you can use here. 2, 9, 5, right? 2, 9, 5 and then 3, 3, 5, then 3. Then 5, right? 5 3 is 15, 15 3 is 45, 290 to 180. But we want perfect square. So if 180 is divisible by all 3, so multiple of 180 will be divided by 4, 9 and 10, right? So multiple of 180 means when we multiply something in 180. So we will check 180 is a perfect square or not. So again, we will do prime factorization here, right? You can see 5 is missing, 1 5 is missing. It means what we have to do? We have to multiply by 5 in 180. So it is 900. So 900 is a perfect square and divisible by 4, 9 and 10, right? So you know there are two things in this question. First of all, we have to find the LCM, right? And LCM, why we are finding? Because they, you know, the question is wanting a number which is divisible by all three, so LCM is that number. But if we are getting LCM 180, but that is not coming a perfect square, so for making it a perfect square, what we will do, we will follow this procedure which we were following in the previous sums. So it means we have two steps here, right? And in the last one, find the smallest square number that is divisible by, again the same question here, only they have changed the value. I hope you can do this sum, and this exercise is complete here. And please try again all the sums for practice, and I hope you will definitely do these sums yourself. Thank you.